Sure.
Okay, we're lucky to have Ellen de Havilland. She's a board member of Summit Public Art, and she'll tell us about Summit Public Art, which has something like 100 installations in Summit. She herself is a Summit resident and runs a private practice called the Music Moment that provides music therapy, music lessons, and community art experiences. And you might know her as the creator of Boxwood's Open Mic Community. And you might have seen her through her involvement with the Creative Summit Community. She's a board member of Summit Public Art and manages their website and media channels. I think I'm going to call her up for advice on something else. But most importantly, love to get people engaged in the arts. And let us hear from you then.
Thank you, Peter. Take it away.
Ellen.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Peter. Really appreciate it. I mean, this is really about Summit Public Art today, not about me. So I want to keep the focus on that. Just a couple of housekeeping things. If you have your viewing and you're trying to see everybody, this is a very visual presentation. So during the art tour, I recommend you change your settings to speaker view. And I'm sure somebody can probably put the instructions in the chat, but if anyone's having a problem with that, if you just want to put a message in the chat to let us know you need further instruction. But I do recommend you put it into speaker view for at least the beginning of this presentation. We're going to do a little virtual arts tour. So first of all, I want to ask, I recognize a lot of faces and names on here. So there's some past board members even on here. Which is very exciting. So they can kind of help fill me in on the history a little bit, because I have actually only been with Summit Public Art for about 5 years. I've lived in Summit 6 or 7 years. So I know Diane Gallo I saw in here and Melanie Cohn have been very involved and have a longer history with it. So it's been around since 2002. Mm-hmm. It was founded as the Mayor's Partnership for Summit Public Art. And just this year, we became a little bit more independent because since the beginning of time, basically, we had the Summit Foundation, used to be SAPF, as our fiscal sponsor. So we officially established the Friends of Summit Public Art this year, which is really just our fundraising arm of it. And Melanie was also very involved in making that happen. So I want to just give a shout out there. Before I move on to the art tour, I just want to see by a show of hands, you can do a little hand raise thing in Zoom, or you can just raise your hand. Most of us are on video. How many of you are familiar with Summit Public Art on any level? Good, good. Looks like most people. Awesome. That's great to hear. I believe most of you are Summit residents. If you see the artwork that pops up around town, the sculptures, often in the green, in the causeway area, we've spread out a little bit, but it's mostly in downtown Summit, all outdoor stuff. That's Summit Public Art. Did I hear something? Did I hear a question? Okay, feel free to interrupt if you have any questions throughout or put them in the chat. I'm looking at that. So just a little correction there, 100 pieces over time we've had. Usually we have maybe 8 to 10 installations at any given time, give or take, outside. But there's not 100 at the moment. So just to make sure nobody's going around searching saying, oh my gosh, where are they all? Currently we have 12, which includes our temporary art as well as our permanent art. So I'm gonna highlight those in a little bit of a virtual tour, and we're gonna move forward on this screen. So this is a nice little map that should give you an idea. This map is available on our website. I will put the website right in the chat so you can click on it. Summitpublicart.com. So if you go to that website, you'll find it in a few different places on there, and you can just download it, print it out if you want. You can view it on your phone. You can also use the virtual tour that's on our website where you can click on all the art and find out about it. But this is a nice way just to kind of see where all of the art is located. And if you want to bring somebody around town and check it out, most of this is all within walking distance. I'd say it's all within walking distance because it's all Summit, but most of it's within the downtown area. So you might have seen this go up last year on the parking garage. This is pretty exciting. It's by, my face is covering a little bit, Tom Fruin. It's called Walk the Streets. This is not by Tom Fruin. I just realized that. Ah, typo. We'll just keep that covered. I was putting this together late last night. So it's by Mikhail Davis, but he's also known as Hellbent. And I saw him in Asbury Park, but he's been all over the place and does very vivid, beautiful, colorful murals with all these patterns. If you've been to Corgi Distillery, he has a really cool mural there as well, which I was excited to find in Jersey City. But this was installed and should be up for several years to come. And this was a very cool project that we worked with the city on to just brighten up the parking garage, make it colorful, adding something. So it's not just gray and, you know, it adds a lot of color. One of the things that Hellbent said that he takes a vast array of colors and patterns and makes them work together. And he thinks that this is what anyone wants from a community. So you're gonna notice a lot of the art as I was going through it. A lot of it is about color, it's about vibrancy. Some of our artwork is about using found materials. It's about celebrating the community around you and the space. So the board members of Summit Public Art get together and choose art based on what will inspire thought, provoke thought, bring the community together. Art can be contemplative. It can be political at times. Sometimes it has a very clear description and other times it's just made to have you look at it and wonder about it. So as you look at these pieces, I want you to think, what does it make you think for you? What does it bring up for you? What does it make you think of? So that's Walk the Streets by Hellbent. And I should also mention that Summit is 100% volunteer run. We don't get any funding support from the city. It is all through donations, grants, our usual annual gala that didn't happen last year, but we just did an awesome social media campaign. And I know that there's some of the funders on here who have supported us through that. So really, thank you so, so much, because without it, without that financial support, you wouldn't see this art around town. So the next piece is called Efflorescence. This is by the artist Kate Dodd. Very beautiful colors, more vibrancy, just like that last one. You see all that color. This was a site-specific installation. So she worked with Summit Public Art to design something that fits in this space. It's in the causeway. If you go right off that main strip, kind of close to Mondo, you'll find this. It's cool because it connects sort of that parking deck area. And what's really wonderful as you walk around the city is you kind of just pop up on these and some of them sneak up on you. So this is a really fun space because it just, wow, what's that there? And you can walk down this little alleyway. It's made of recycled plastic bottles and there's some nets that are from onions and garlics actually that add to that color and vibrancy. There's 14 flower-like stalks, and one of the things that the artist said about this, what is there a lot of in the world that people don't value? Plastic bottles. It's huge. It's actually appeared in our artwork before as well. She's very into turning nothing into something. She wants to she has a need to bring order to chaos. It doesn't make sense to me to make new objects when the world is already so full of objects, and almost nothing seems as ever-present and unwanted as plastic bottles. So I thought that was a really poignant part of her artist statement and this piece. again, recycled materials, vibrant colors. And you might see a theme in this, just sometimes happens. What lifts you? We have a little hashtag with this one. Hashtag what lifts you. Again, this one's kind of hidden a little bit, unless you park in the parking lots behind the main strip on Springfield. This is actually on the shared wall where barbacoa is. That food is delicious if you've had a chance to pick it up. They also make awesome drinks. And this was an awesome work because we actually partnered with Summit Downtown Inc. and Dylan Baker, who owns Barbacoa as well as the Summit House restaurant. So between the three organizations, we were able to fund this artwork by Kelsey Montague. And it's often that we need to work with other people to bring in these bigger name artists and these big works. Kelsey Montague has done these murals throughout the country, and it's part of a series where she invites you to interact with the art and take a picture. This is actually one of our Instagram followers who has posted several pictures with Summit Public Art. And she's wearing these wings. So it's a very playful piece. Again, more of that color. There's a couple of really neat things in here. If you look closely, you'll find a dragonfly. When she toured around Summit, she said, they can be found in any garden here, which I have seen quite a few. I don't know if they come to my garden though. I need some help with that. There's a train to represent the New York direct train we have. And there is also sunflowers. She found a sunflower garden real close by. So it's just to represent the community that we share here. And I think it just brings us all together. It shows collaborative work amongst nonprofit organizations, and it invites people, it doesn't matter what background you come from, to come and just enjoy it and interact with the art. So this is one of those more interactive pieces that's been a lot of fun. This was installed 1 or 2 years ago by Paul Santillari. It's called The Watcher, and it is a mural that is on the back of the building. I always say it's next to Mondo. There's that little road there where the Greek Grill is, or not Mondo, the Boxwood Coffee, sorry. Where the Greek Grill and Boxwood Coffee are, there's that parking lot and there's a little parklet there. So it's a beautiful area to sit. Paul Santillari, his work encompasses a variety of media, but endlessly returns to the stories found in the drawn line. So all those swirls and lines are very common in Paul's work. If anyone has any questions about any particular artwork, please let me know. This one is called Love Long Last. When they were first installed, it was like, whoa, what are these big things? And you walk up to them and you see these beautiful red cardinals. This is by Donna Dodson and Andy Moreland. They're known as the Myth Makers. And it was really interesting when I was kind of reviewing the notes about this piece. They're monumental in scale. They tend to make pieces out of natural materials. Natural materials, they're site specific. So they designed these just for us in Summit here. And they add chapter to the life stories in the communities in which they appear. There's a belief that cardinals are spiritual messengers, and that has existed from throughout many cultures. They're seen as signs of good health, renewal, and happy relationships. So using those natural materials, there's these, at the top of the one cardinal, well, actually, I think it's on both of them, there's these little windmill-like things that blow in the wind, and it's just very playful. It's beautiful. I like to explore a lot of these pieces with my two-year-old, and we actually just went around in the snow yesterday, and she loved running in circles around these things, but kept looking at them and saying, too scary, because they're very big. most people have seen this as you're driving into Summit, maybe when you go to the grocery store and you're coming back into the city. It's by Dow Bloomberg. And it is an homage to Summit, the City of Trees. So this beautiful sculpture, it was originally called the Silver Sentinel, was built as a permanent piece. And I believe this was located on the green for a while before it was moved here to this location. And it was recently made as a dedication to one of our board members who passed, Matt Gould, who many of you probably knew also as a councilman, just in memory of his work and his dedication to our city and all his talent that he brought. Bloomberg shared a note when he installed this piece. When I do a piece, my goal is to capture something special in it. I'm not interested in pretty. I want a spark of life. I thought that was interesting because I find this quite beautiful, especially with the snow. Anything that makes this tree sparkle more, it's really just beautiful. I love it. The next one has become sort of an icon of Summit Public Art. This is Brickhead Love by James Tyler. And I apologize where I put the captions here. My head covers them. I should have tested it with this cool new technology next time. But I wanted to put this little zoom in here because if you haven't walked up to this piece, you've probably seen it driving by or walking by, but you may not have noticed that all of the bricks in this piece are engraved with the word love. And it's, you know, in different ways. These are just ceramic brick pieces. This is a colossal sculpture that weighs, 5,000 pounds, and it stands 8 feet tall. It's become a little bit of an icon, especially with the pandemic. One day, somebody put a mask on it. We don't know whether they did it at night. They did it very stealthy. We didn't know it happened. And we looked and we're like, wow, that's pretty creative. A couple days later, that mask was taken down. We're not sure if somebody took it down because they were feeling like the art was covered or what it was, or if it was just stolen. We're not really sure, but we had talked to the artist and the artist absolutely loved it. And we realized his sculptures across the country like this, because he has brickhead sculptures across the country, a lot of them had these masks on them that were made by people and put on. So we actually had a local resident help us to, a seamstress help us to put together another mask. And this is two of our board members putting that on. So Terry Jacobs, if anyone knows her, sewed this mask for us generously and donated it so that we could put another mask on and really keep that icon there. Currently, it doesn't have a mask. Once again, it was taken off. It happens. Luckily, the artwork is okay and not touched. And if you walk up to the piece, there's also a sound element to it. One of the things that I thought was very interesting that James Tyler shared, he says each of his heads is handmade and unique, but universal, bringing together today's faces with pre-Columbian, South American, Native American, Asian, African, and Western influences. They are us. And he said they're not of a specific person. So that's just one of those things. Sometimes people make art to be very particular and specific. Sometimes they just want you to look at it and make your own conclusions. Or just to let it be art. This is another one that was installed this last year, Anomie Exquisite by Andrew Light. This is, again, using scrapyard finds, and it was a random series where he created the base and then that piece that kind of takes flight off of the base. Light reimagined the function of these discarded materials to create a dynamic new work defined by its central arc. From the twin cylinders that function at its base, a reminder of its junkyard origins, the resulting piece ascends and takes flight on curved wings that carry it into new harmony and purpose, evoking what Light calls the echo of a movement. Again, this piece just kind of seems to fit our time right now, which is really, it's cool how that happens. That was not intentional. This is another piece some people don't realize attributed to Summit Public Art. The bus shelters that surround just in front of the train station entrance there have these beautiful stained glass windows. There's Arboretum, which is of course dedicated to our local Arboretum, Reeves Reed. Spring and Fall, and While Waiting. And they're really beautiful when you go up close to really look at them. Here's another one. You'll notice a lot of our pieces now have light. So I wanted to feature the day and night aspect of this because they look so different in day and night. This is Troika by Aurora Robeson. And she had some interesting things about this. So I'm gonna just read about it. It was inspired by the recurring images that haunted her dreams when she was a child. This curiously shaped trio sculpted from plastic debris is the result of Robeson's practice of transforming bad into good, turning displaced abundance into works of art. Seen at night, her sculptures, lit by internal solar-powered lights, become enchanted objects that grow from within. And that's her words. She defines her approach to art as a meditative practice of transformation, where the goal is to establish value where it ought to have been recognized in the first place. Again, recycled materials. Really cool what you can do with them. Another exhibit, which is not gone, it's just moved. This is Summit Under Quarantine, also called In This Together. The name sort of changed as COVID moved on. This was really a response to this year and everything that was happening. Summit Public Art commissioned artist Joni Schwartz, who's a local photographer, to take photos around for a few weeks of the empty streets and all the people helping and supporting our community and coming together. So this piece is dedicated to the mayors of Summit, past and present. We had a couple of our mayors also donate to support this installation so that we could print these pieces and have them displayed on the green. Originally, this was a social media thing. It was posted on Instagram and on our website so you could see all the pictures and comment and share and interact with them there because we were trying to create a safe environment for people where they didn't need to go outside. What's cool is this just creates more accessibility too for people, which I love about the website because if you can't get out, if you can't get around, you can see all about it on the website. And we try to keep our social media active so people can also engage and interact. So you'll see in the picture on the right here, you could come up and take a selfie of yourself wearing a mask in it. And again, under that beautiful brick head sculpture with the mask on it. And just that moment of them putting the mask on just really seems to represent our time. So that's been an iconic snapshot. If you want to see this in person, we actually moved it to the Summit Public Library. And they have a gallery there that often the Visual Arts Center has their artwork featured in. And there was a gap in time, so we decided, hey, let's get our art in there and cover those walls. And it looks absolutely beautiful there. So hopefully the library will be open for us to visit soon. And you can go and see it there. Even if you saw it on the green, it's just really cool to see it in that other space. Yes, this was just another beautiful piece that really brought us together. I told you it's kind of changed from Summit Under Quarantine to In This Together. The artist's statement, she said, as I traveled through town, I recognized the thousands of people dutifully remaining at home. I saw essential workers courageously venturing out to ensure hospitals ran, and I witnessed the food supply chains struggling to function. My perspective changed. I wasn't seeing restrictions and loneliness anymore. I was viewing love in action. And I just think that says so much about our Summit community. Really beautiful. Some of these pictures are still available for sale. The prints, actually any of the ones in the library now are available. You can view what's available also on our website if you go to summitpublicart.com/SUQ for Summit Under Quarantine. You will find all of the artwork priced very reasonably. I think it was $150 for the small prints and $200 or $250 for the large ones. And the money from that goes back to Summit Public Art so we can continue to produce more art and helps fund these installations. So if you are interested in purchasing a little remnant of this exhibition, it is available, which is very cool. Another piece here is, I'm going to try to pronounce this correct, but I pronounce it differently every time I say it, Maxi Kiosko. And this is the one by Tom Fruin. Can you tell I was copying slide layout a little bit? this is really cool. It's near City Hall. All of you can probably tell which ones are my favorites because I get very excited about them. Hello, Maddie. My baby is here and she enjoyed, say hi. She enjoyed coming and just running around this house, walking around it, going in it, looking in all the colorful windows. Again, color, light. This was plexiglass and steel, all reused materials, recycled materials. Being right at City Hall is a nice location. It just brings some light to that area. And it's really beautiful. There's some benches in that area. So if you have a chance to get out, grab a sandwich or something from somewhere downtown to support that local restaurant and come sit near the art and enjoy it. This is all outside, so it's all safe. Just wear a mask if people are around. And that is the end of the virtual art tour. So before I wrap up, does anybody have any questions about any of that?
Yes, a beautiful presentation, and your enthusiasm comes through very clearly. Have you had any problems with graffiti or other than the mask removal from the one statue? Has that been a problem?
We've had a few issues, not so much graffiti, but sometimes people climbing on sculptures, they break them or pulling a piece off. All of our art is insured, so usually the artist comes in and fixes it. Another piece that's actually just going to come up, I have three pieces that I'm just going to highlight from where we were getting the community a little more engaged. And it's the Togetherness Trail. Actually, I'll just zoom ahead to it. And we had a big storm that the trees knocked down a ton of this trail. And unfortunately, it was a temporary piece. And it was going to come down soon anyways, but we had to bring it down sooner because all of the path was just blocked and there were pieces everywhere from those trees. So it does happen from time to time, unfortunately. Thankfully, the insurance, you know, covers that, and we're always very careful. The city always reviews all our pieces to make sure that they are safe. And any of the ones that have, you know, something kids could climb on, we really try to make sure that they're on a base or something that people can't really climb on them and get hurt. But it does happen, unfortunately. We don't have cameras everywhere in the city, so we don't always know what happened or how it happened. We do encourage Summit residents, though, if you ever see anything, to just let us know. You can shoot us an email. You can reach out to the city. They'll make sure we know, and we'll make sure we address it right away.
Thank you.
Great question.
Yeah, I have a question. I noticed your website, which I'm anxious to explore, is a .com. And I'm under the impression that I happen to be on the board of the Summit Foundation, that when you set up, you're a 501c3, are you not?
We are, and actually .org will go to that website as well. It all redirects.
Okay.
It's just .com when we formed the website was more popular. Sometimes on applications for grants and stuff, I will write .org because people want to see that. It all goes to the same website.
Okay.
We are officially our own 501c3 this year as we became more independently financially responsible. And we thank Summit Area Foundation, now Summit Foundation, for all their support over the years as well, and continued support. They're continuing to support us into 2021 with some wonderful grants and projects.
Indeed.
This was a great presentation. I don't know if you could see me or not. Can you?
Yep.
I can.
Okay. I can't see myself. It's someone who's you know, was served in City Hall for many years and walks around Summit a lot, as I'm a pedestrian most days. And as someone who's married to someone who was on the board, I have many different perspectives on your delightful presentation. I really do sense your enthusiasm, but I can recall the bemusement of Summit city officials when the first pieces of art went out. They didn't know what to make of what they had created. I mean, Janet Whitman was clearly the most enthusiastic supporter as the mayor.
Right.
But there were councilmen, I'll leave them unnamed, who just really rolled their eyes. And I think, and as someone who watched his wife go out the door many an evening to sit at meetings and take minutes and the like, I had a different perspective. And so I know there's a big committee of hardworking people that have worked on this for many years, but I think the intentionality and the enthusiasm of the group has won over the city. It's just it's a great, great institution. And it's wonderful to see it continue.
Thank you. And thank you for all your support over the years too.
Hi, Ellen.
So many people on this call. Hi.
Hi, may I speak?
Absolutely.
I'm fairly new. I was in Summit 3 years and on Rotary a bit less. And I used to marvel at these wonderful things near the train station and wonder how the hell they got there and thinking, what politician would ever do that? So I'm just delighted to get a proper answer to it. But I think that there must be, we have an extraordinarily active and connected group here. But I think there must be a lot of us who really didn't know where you came from. I think you need to tell your story even more than you have.
Thank you for that feedback. I actually managed the social media pages. Before I joined the board, there wasn't really a proper Facebook group. A lot of that stuff. So a lot of that's new. We started to brand with the logo and the colors. We started to do more signage. So we're trying. As a nonprofits organization, you all understand, you know, we have limited resources. It's 100% volunteer board. So we do what we can. We feel like it's changed a lot in the last couple of years, including getting more youth. We've built in accessibility opportunities. And I used to work at the Arc of Union County as the development director. So we used to get tours of adults from the day habilitation program and group homes to come and check it out. So just opportunities to really engage more people has helped us to get our word out. But we appreciate all of you. If you go onto our social media pages, I might sound like a repeating record on that, but it really will keep you up to date on what the latest art is. Whether you like it or hate it, we want to hear about it, because, you know, it's the Summit residents who say, you know, this piece wasn't really my style. And that helps us also to determine what people respond well to for future pieces. You can also recommend artists, or if you are an artist, you can submit an art application for something. All the feedback, we really appreciate it. Getting our name out, helping to let people know whenever we have events, if you can't attend them, if you can share them, that would be really wonderful. If you are looking for more volunteer opportunities outside of the Rotary, feel free to join us. Join us on, there's so many ways you can join us. So, you know, maybe you want to be a committee member, maybe you just want to help with some projects, you can email us for information about that.
Ellen, this is Susan, and it's a beautiful presentation. Hi, it is so exciting. Just two questions. I think you probably said how many there are total. And then my other question is just an invitation for you to quickly give a little context nationally. I would say that the last 30 years has really been a gradual shift in perception. The whole downtown movement, the whole Richard Florida thing. So now city planners integrate arts. Everybody knows that it builds value. So do you see this as kind of, I know Summit's kind of ahead of it, but it is happening in a lot of places. Do you see it as something broader, partly the creativity movement, the creative placemaking movement, just all these things have converged and coalesced?
Absolutely. And Susan and I go back from some various creative projects. So thank you for bringing this up. I'm very passionate about how the arts I'll help engage community, bring people together. I'm a music therapist by trade. And I really got involved with Summit Public Art through music therapy and community arts engagement experiences. I learned it when I moved to New Jersey about what creative placemaking is. And it's really about creating places, spaces where arts and business and government can come together to create a space where people can explore ideas, discuss, you know, the Black Lives Matter movement was huge. You see the, on the road, you see written, I think they did it in Philadelphia and London, all over the cities where they wrote it in big black or big colorful paint on the blacktop to just say Black Lives Matter. And that was so poignant. And you'd see those images, and it's of our time, creative spaces, people coming together, and all of that, whether it's political, whether it's for the beauty of this land, whether it's art for art's sake, it all helps our communities to thrive. It helps us to show who lives in our community, to celebrate the people, to celebrate the diversity of people. We try to do art that's representative of the people of Summit and of the area of Summit. And we try to really bring in stuff that encourages inquiry and discussion around that. We try to avoid being overly political a lot of times because that is what it is. But, you know, it's important, and there's a huge economic impact. The art brings people. I would love to see Summit featured as an arts destination. I feel like it is, personally. All the art galleries we have, the Visual Arts Center is huge, and the dance studios, there's some incredible institutions and organizations right in our city that makes it an incredible arts destination. And I would love to see more and more people coming here to see that, and then in turn supporting those businesses and helping us as an economy.
My name is Nathan, and I was the former superintendent of schools in Summit. I don't live in Summit, but I have a son who's an art professor actually in Southern Oregon University. But I just want to compliment you on your presentation. And if I was the superintendent of the schools, I think the art, the visual arts, and it is much more interesting now than it has been in a long time. When I was there, I didn't find it as interesting as what you just showed. I think it's fantastic what you've done, and I love the way you've placed art in the context of a more understanding of each other and the world as a whole. So I think it's really terrific. And my son did quite a bit of public art in LA area. And I think that what you said is confirmed throughout the country, really.
Yeah. And there's a big movement happening where it's becoming, people are more aware of the importance of the art throughout our lives. COVID brought a lot of attention to that. Where do we turn when, you know, we're stressed and we need a release? Sometimes it's the arts, so.
You know, Ellen, on behalf of the Rotary, I think we're so appreciative of what you've done, the enthusiastic presence that you bring to the project. And there's one hope as we move forward this year that we will truly all be able to be out there, outside, appreciating all this fabulous art that's there. Unfortunately, many are still huddled in their homes for good reason, but I look forward to being able to have the community brought together through the vehicle of art. So I can't thank you enough.
And join the Facebook page to see a lot of the commentary and join that. You know, you don't have to comment on it. You don't have to have a Facebook profile, or you can view Instagram to see a lot of that. I don't know if people want to hear a little more. I know we're probably running out of time here. I had a little bit about some other artwork, but I can just kind of go through the tiles here.
Sure.
There's Big Sister that was on the YMCA building. That was a collaborative experience where adults with disabilities did all these strings of beads. That's what those are, strings of bead on yarn, to build this beautiful sculpture. And that was installed on the YMCA just across from the library. Our ramp up initiative got high school students involved. We really made a push. We realized the youth needed opportunities. So this is our Rising Artists Mentorship Program, and it's for students specifically interested in visual arts as a career, and they get to work with a professional artist. This is Dan Fenelon that worked with them in building the Spirit of Summit. And they came up with the idea and worked with the artist through a couple of months to create this. So that happened a couple of years ago, and we've done a few ramp ups now. And the togetherness trail that I mentioned, that was in partnership with the Park Line. Again, another nonprofit collaboration that made this 10th of a mile walkway that you could see right from Morris Ave. We had it lit up because there was a resident that donated the funds for the electricity and the lights and put those on. Again, volunteers made this all happen. Without the Park Line Foundation, we wouldn't have been able to fund this project. And that's what we're looking to engage the community. We're looking for people to come. We did public art workshops with that last one. We're looking for people to come together and be part of the experience, to learn more about the art. So
thank you.